This is Matt Glumack, the autistic golfer. How you guys doing? So today is November 23rd, and we are here at Goat Hill Park for the 2019 Wishbone Brawl. We came here last year when Xander Schauffele, Mike Weir, Charlie Hoffman, and Dean Wilson played, and it was so much fun to watch. And so we've come back again this year, and this year we're going to be seeing, once again, Xander Schauffele, Dean Wilson, and today, U.S. Open champion Geoff Ogilvy and local pro Chris Riley from SDU. So this is going to be a lot of fun today, so let's get ready for the clink.
Say thank you.
Did you get your things on?
Oh,
thank you. It's fading.
Oh, can you get it back?
Please, yeah.
Oh, thank you so much. There.
You have to worry about how you're playing, you know, get all mad when you lose a
fun being out there and a bunch of all the boys and hanging out with Nick Price and Ernie Earls at that close proximity is great. We're going to do that again in Melbourne. Tigers are playing because they're on the side of themselves in Australia. The Tigers are going to come play. So pretty exciting. It's Australia's best ball Sunday. Getting a big great experience with guys like Xander to see conditions like that. The greens are going to be quick. And, Augusta style kind of putting and stuff you get out there on the other side of the world. So, yeah, great event. Melbourne has a close, great big event. A lot of people turn around, they'll get loud and rowdy, so it'll be fun.
You're known as one of the golf purists. You still like to play the game on time. You still take pressure. You still carry your own bag. The idea of playing in the same woods is probably something that you do on a certain regular basis, but look forward to. What is it about, this past technology and the certain woods that you think is so special? And how do games play important to stay in touch with you?
Yeah, I mean it's like a vinyl record or like a vintage car or something. If that's your thing and you really appreciate the beauty of the craft and what you're supposed to do. It's not every drive you buy right now is actual stuff. These are all different and they're still all different. There's something interesting about everyone's having a slightly different experience and it's a bit more organic than it's been physical. I don't know if it sounds great, it's like the metal spikes from the car park or those. I like everything about every gear of golf, and I just try to kind of, I like to feel golf like the Sleeds and the Hogans and the Nicholas and the game they played. It's kind of fun to go back and play that a little bit to see what it's like.
He hits fast. Hot.
Sit. Ooh, very nice. Dang!
That's it.
It stayed up.
Oh, that was a little chunky. Coming in hot.
Nope. A little chunky, no spin. Up on the back edge.
Oh yes. There we go. Oh. Whoa! Almost hold out. Oh, come back a little. Nice. You're pumped after making that birdie. Spin. Oh. Wrong spin. What are you doing, little girl? Run! Whoa. Ooh, Dean. Good. Oh, Geoff.
All right, let's hear it for Geoff Ogilvy.
Wishbone Brawl has officially begun. Magnet over there. Good shot, Dean. Yeah, great putt. Good putt, Chris. Oh, nice birdie, Dean. Be the right club. Oh. Go, Ed. Yeah, I think so. That'll kick off the hill there. Yep. Oh, sit. Don't go too far now. Oh! Oh, that's money right there. Be right. Oh, goated.
Got a chance. Go a little bit. Oh, go in the hole. Come on.
Oh my gosh. Whoa. What a great shot. Fade. Great shot from Xander Schauffele, and now Dean Wilson. Nice shot from Dean Wilson.
Bump and run, release, get up there.
Yeah. Well, it gets heavier every 9 minutes.
That one. Oh!
Come on, a lot, icy plant.
Whoa!
Whoa, sit! Four!
Heads up!
Oh,
yeah, golf shot!
Wow!
Okay, good, good. All right.
Riley!
Goated. Get. Goated. Draw. Be right. Goated. Ah. Nice shot. Wow, that was, what a shot from right there. Oh, perfect distance.
Get in.
Run away, dog.
No, no, no. No. Oh my gosh. That was hilarious.
Get in there.
Oh. Oh, that's going right at it. Be the right distance. Spin back.
Great shot.
Eagle putt.
Oh, wow, that's crazy.
Heavy wind or something there, right?
Oh, boy. Draw. Oh, good effort. Oh! Come on, Dean.
Mud. Mud got him.
Truly, champ.
Be right. Oh, great distance. Good line. Wow. Come on, Dean. Yeah! Woo! Yeah, Dean!
By holding this putt, Dean Wilson and Xander Schauffele forced a sudden-death playoff with Geoff Ogilvy and Chris Riley. The playoff would begin on the ninth hole and continue on to the first hole in the 18th hole.
Be the right distance. Okay. All right, good distance.
That's makeable. Real safe.
Uh-oh.
Get!
Oh, that looks
gotta
good.
Gotta go a little bit.
Get up!
Oh!
Yeah! Stop!
Oh, no!
Oh, don't get goated now.
Oh, way goated.
It was at this moment that my phone ran out of film. As I was switching batteries in my camera, Geoff Ogilvy hit his shot. Here is what happened. Geoff Ogilvy made a hole in one! Oh man.
Hey, that's so good. Dude, I heard it and I'm like, where did it bounce?
I love looking for it.
Hey, Dean, I guess we can lose it that.
That's a good way to lose it.
Holy s.
Oh man.
Oh my god, Geoff Ogilvy was
Castleman's, mate. Castleman's.
Oh my god. Oh,
ouch.
Oh my god. Unbelievable. Geoff Ogilvy just hit a hole in one to win.
It was without a doubt one of the most incredible things that I have seen in golf. I don't know if it was a shot heard around the world, but it definitely was a shot heard around Oceanside. I'll bet you could have heard that roar from Main Street. I will never forget it.
Let's go look at the ball.
Bro.
Oh my gosh. So Geoff Ogilvy.
Wow.
Come get it.
You gotta get it. Come on.
Good job, Geoff. Good job,
Geoff.
Awesome, bro. Bro, let's go.
What club was that?
Wow.
Hell of a shot.
Oh my god.
Jared.
It's burning, bro.
That is absolutely
the coolest thing I've ever
seen. That's
the hardest.
Confirm that even, but I just went with it. I went with it because that's what needed to be done. Your foundation is in the negative. Explain that to the board. I mean, what?
I mean, stupid, right? I mean, yeah, hole in one. We just went and extend the drama a little bit, give Dave a little bit of candy on the last to make birdie, and then we just finish him off on the next one.
How many? What was the yardage? What club? Let's get some specifics here.
132 downhill. My pitching wedge kind of goes high 30s, so I hit wedge over the green first time, so I'll just hit a little bit softer and see how it goes. And Ash called it as soon as it was in the air. He's like, wow, that's good. That looks good. Wow, that looks good. And then we couldn't really see it go in the hole, but it was fairly evident where the ball went.
How many aces is this for you?
I think that's number 9, actually.
So he's an 8-time winner on the PGA Tour. He has 9 aces, and we can call this a win on the PGA Tour.
Yeah.
I think we can call it a win. 9-9. What? Just talk about all. What, did you ever find yourself sort of looking around and kind of trying to see? Like, have you ever been a part of something as special as what's going on right now?
Nah, that was crazy. That was super crazy. I mean, I just saw Jonathan Bird did that in Vegas, right, a few years back to win the tournament. But it was super dark and.
It also wasn't for a Wishbone Brawl, and it wasn't, it wasn't for a couple thousand in skins,
It wasn't very important, really. This was a bit more important. So, yeah, I mean, I got Chris Riley carried me all day, so I thought I should do something at the end. So he weighed me, I weighed him down all day, and then I let him loose on the last, so.
Guys, Geoff Ogilvy just won the Wishbone Brawl with a rock up ace! With a rock up ace! The only guy who was better on the greens than Geoff Ogilvy was his partner, Chris Riley. I mean, he made everything from 132. You made everything from everywhere else.
Man, that was what a great day. But I think we really need to take our hats off to Dean Wilson and John Ashworth for starting this up 3 years ago.
Yeah.
without these guys, without their vision and all this, this wouldn't happen. Yeah. And I was just so excited when they called me. They didn't even have to ask me. I was like, yes, I'm playing. So thank you guys. Thanks for the crowds that come out and support this. It's going to a great cause in junior golf. And I mean, it's just what a way to end with Geoff Ogilvy. I mean, I got to tell a quick story. In 2001, he was a rookie, and I was paired with him, and we're playing Tucson. And this guy hit a 2-iron, and I'd never seen anybody hit a golf ball like this. And it's high like a pitching wedge, and it landed. And I knew this kid was going to be special. And I'm 4 years older, and he was always another level than me on the PGA Tour. But great person, great family, and
great shot,
and a great shot. Yeah. Chris,
just for a second, just to give everybody a little insight, this you kind of might use this as some momentum to go back to get your amateur stat. This is what you were talking about.
Yes. I don't know. You never know what's going to happen. I'm the coach of USD right now. I'm loving it. I'm not going to let these San Diego kids get away. I'll tell you that. We got to keep them in San Diego. I'm building a big program here. In the next year or two, it's going to be crazy how good we're going to be at USD.
How many scholarships did you offer out there today?
3 or 4.
Guys, Geoff Ogilvy and Chris Riley for the 2019 season.
Let me go! Come on,
D! You can take that, right? I mean, what a show. That's unbelievable. That's about the coolest thing I've ever seen. So, thanks for coming out here. Ash, thanks to you and your crew getting everything together. The course is awesome. I can't think of a more fun thing to do than come out here and play in this kind of format in front of all our friends and the community. It's awesome. Thanks for coming out. What a great special day. Best ending I've ever seen in my life.
And we'll see you next year.
That's right. We'll see you next year.
Yes.
Where's Xander Schauffele? Number 9 in the world just got beat. This is a little precursor to a little President's Cup. Nice captain just taking down playing number here. What?
Yeah, maybe they should throw their vice captain on the team.
So you guys are using your captain. Why not use the vice captain?
We'll switch a room here. Huh? Yeah, that was ridiculous. I'm just glad Dean and I were able to win the skins on 18. I didn't want too much money to go down under. So. No, it was. I think this kind of finish is, fortunately for us, going to drag Geoff back here next year. So,
you got to have him going, Geoff.
We can do this again next year.
Guys, Xander Schauffele took a break out of one of the most ridiculous schedules in the history of professional golf to come out here and spend time with us as number 9 in the world. Give him a round of applause. Ashley, come on up. I'd like to let you do the honors of reflecting on what just took place and then also giving the Wishbone trophy to the winner.
I have no idea how we top this next year, but unbelievable. Thanks everybody for coming out. Couldn't have gone better. Weather, people, players, Matty G. Big round of applause.
Keeping
everybody up to speed on what's going on. Anyway, we're stoked. Thanks for coming out. I have the trophy right here. It's the Wishbone. And that's going to go to our boys, Geoff Ogilvy and Chris Riley. You know, they won the trophy, but they kind of came in second place in the cash. which is all right, $6,000 worth. $6,000 from Truly, our sponsor. What a great job. Yeah, that's right. 9 Australian. So take that.
9 Australian.
Take that. All right, get in here. Chris.
Guys, by the way, the game of golf wins again today. This is about the growth of the game. This is about mini munis, Persimmon Woods, real players having an amazing event, an amazing day. Couldn't have done this without everybody who came out today to support this. I mean, it just doesn't get it. If this isn't the purest form of what's good about the game of golf, I don't know what is. So round of applause for everybody involved. Golfers Journal, by the way, Meg, Tara, in addition to Truly, everybody that's been a part of this, Matt, for all the great vocals. We're going to have some live music, the food, the party continues. Let's go. Let's go.
We're kind of running low on food. We apologize for that. We didn't know how many people were going to show up, and it really exceeded our expectations, so thank you.
Dean.
Well, my friends, oh my God. I never, ever expected the tournament to end like that. Oh my gosh, that was incredible. Geoff Ogilvy makes a hole-in-one on the playoff hole. Like, what? I can't believe it. And I didn't even see it go in the hole. That would have been, oh, because I'm trying to get my camera to work in. That's epic, though. That's just, what a way to win a tournament with a hole-in-one. He truly deserved it. And I actually donated $10 to his foundation when I bought the ticket. And then he goes and makes a hole-in-one. It's an omen, like. Wow. And, you know, to be able to meet him and all the rest of the players, you know, it was really nice. I didn't meet Dean and Xander last year, but I did this year, so. But to finish off with a hole-in-one, incredible. I don't know if I'll ever see something like that again. The first hole-in-one I witnessed was a few years ago at Encinitas Ranch, and it was actually the second time I played, and wasn't my hole-in-one. I never had a hole-in-one yet. It was with a regular member who I play with there. And in fact, that was the first time I played with him. But that's incredible. Incredible finish to the 2019 Wishbone Brawl. So that's going to be it for today, everybody. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell. And I will be seeing you in my next video.